Hello, friends and citizens of Sacramento. My name is Nicole May, and I am the project manager for the American River Common Features 2016 project. In lieu of a public meeting, we felt that this video is the safest way to keep you updated on our flood risk reduction effort and what can be expected in the near future. As you watch this video and review the other posted materials, you may have questions. Please submit all questions to our public affairs office. The contact information is on the last slide of this presentation, as well as at the bottom of our website, sacleveeupgrades.com. Now that the logistics are done and before I get into the presentation, I'd like to talk to you a little bit about the project in a very general manner. First, it's important to keep in mind two things. One, there is a major flood risk in Sacramento. Given the confluence of two major rivers and the location of the city and our neighborhoods, it has been said to be the number one urban flood risk in the nation. Two, we've been given an amazing opportunity to proactively reduce that risk with this project. The project that I'm referring to is what we call the American River Common Features 2016 project, or because we like to use our acronyms, ARCF 16. The project as a whole is much larger than the focus of this presentation, so I will give you a very brief overview in the coming slides. The project was authorized in 2016 to be constructed in 10 years. In 2018, something very unique happened. Congress set aside $15 billion in emergency supplemental funding, $10 billion for areas impacted by Hurricane Harvey, Irma, and Maria, and $5 billion to states that had two or more declarations of national flood emergencies in a span of 3 years. California qualified, and our project, along with many others, was submitted and approved to receive some of this funding. In fact, we received $1.5 billion of the $5 billion set aside for states. What that says is, on a national platform, this project is considered to address significant risk worthy of significant immediate federal investment. Full funding of federal projects of this size, scope, and magnitude is unheard of, and again, an amazing opportunity. It allows us to look at how to approach the project in a more cost-effective and efficient manner, and that means we will be complete in much less time. Here is an overview of what we will discuss today. I'll just skip right by that. Here is an overview of the system. The project is part of an overall flood risk reduction system, which is shown here. Beginning at Folsom Dam, we most recently completed the joint federal project and auxiliary spillway improvements in 2017. Moving down the American River, we completed seepage and stability improvements in 2016, and now we're fully funded to complete levee improvements to address erosion to be constructed 2022 through 2024. In Natomas, we've made significant improvements over the last several years and are actively under construction. Widening the Sacramento Weir and Bypass is a fully funded portion of this project and is anticipated to begin construction in 2022. And then on the Sacramento River, we have the West Levee improvements currently authorized and receiving funding, and the East Levee improvements, which are fully funded with our project and are anticipated to be in construction through 2023. It is important to note that this is a team effort at all levels of government. We, the Army Corps of Engineers at the federal level, the Central Valley Flood Protection Board, working primarily through the Department of Water Resources at the state level, and the Sacramento Area Flood Control Agency at the local level. Here's an overview of the larger American River Common Features 2016 project. The project is to reduce the flood risk associated with the confluence of the American and Sacramento rivers, which both have very large watersheds with high potential runoff. The project improvements reduce risk primarily on the American River South Basin and the American River North Basin to approximately 500,000 people and 125,000 structures. The authorization includes up to 11 miles of levee improvements on the lower American River to address erosion, and up to 28 miles of levee improvements on the Sacramento River and its tributaries to address seepage, stability, overtopping, and erosion, as well as approximately doubling the size of the Sacramento Weir and Bypass. The bottom line is it's a lot of work to reduce the risk to many communities with large populations. there is a very real flood risk, and that is what all of this is to address. The American River Common Features Project has already completed levee improvements in the American River North Basin in 2019 and constructed a 400-foot berm just south of Old Sacramento. Tonight is to discuss the next major construction effort, entitled Sacramento River East Levee Contract 1, or SREL Contract 1.
Hello, my name is Hans Carota. I am a civil engineer with the Corps of Engineers Sacramento District, and I am the lead engineer on the American River Common Features Project. I'll be giving an overview of the Sacramento River East Levee Contract 1 construction project. However, before I do, let me speak to the four modes of failure which threaten levees. There's overtopping, when the river height exceeds the height of the levee, erosion, where the river erodes into the levee embankment, and seepage failures, which can present in two forms: boils forming on landside of levee, or landside slope failures. Contract 1 focuses on addressing seepage issues in the pocket areas and Miller Park areas. As many of you are likely aware, during high water events, seepage is readily spotted along edges of sidewalks and front yards of homes, which are located near the levees in the pocket areas. So what is seepage, and how are seepage issues addressed? Seepage is the flow of water through the ground, both through the levee embankment, referred to as through seepage, and beneath the levee embankment, referred to as under seepage. Seepage issues can be addressed in two forms: construction of seepage berms on the land side of levee, or construction of seepage cutoff walls through the levee embankment and into the levee foundation. Now on to the Contract 1 overview. A quick piece of background information. Contract 1 is the first in a series of four construction contracts planned, which will construct seepage and stability improvements along the Sacramento River East Levee. When all four contracts are completed, it will reduce the risk to over 500,000 people, 125,000 structures, and protect $62 billion in property. Contract 1 improvements include 1,000 feet of seepage stability berms shown in yellow in the graphic on the left, approximately 2.6 miles of seepage cutoff walls shown in red and brown, and two minor erosion repairs shown in blue. What will construction of Contract 1 look like? For seepage and stability berms, we'll be placing fill on the landside slope and landward of the levee to counteract seepage forces through and beneath the levee. This fill is typically 5 feet thick and can sometimes contain a drainage layer to safely release seepage pressures. Construction of a seepage cutoff wall entails the construction of a trench through the levee and into the levee foundation, which is then backfilled with a low permeability clay and/or cement mixture, which effectively cuts off the seepage through the levee and beneath the levee. Construction of this cutoff wall requires the removal of the top one-third to one-half of the levee height. This removal is necessary to provide sufficient space for the construction equipment to construct the cutoff wall and to mix the contents of the cutoff wall before placing them within the trench. Now let's go into the details of exactly what we're going to be constructing and where. In the Miller Park area, near the junction of Interstate 5 and Business 80, we'll be constructing a 550-foot-long drain stability berm, 527-foot-long seepage berm, and a 950-foot-long seepage cutoff wall. The drain stability berm, located immediately north of Business 80, shown in orange, will begin construction in July. The seepage berm, located south of Front Street, shown in orange, will be constructed in July as well. The seepage cutoff wall, shown in red, located in the northern parking lot of the marina, will not begin construction until after Labor Day this September. Construction of the seepage cutoff wall will be limited to weekdays only to limit impacts to the marina and users of the boat launch facility. Haul routes for construction equipment will be along Interstate 5, Broadway, Front Street, 3rd Street, and 5th Street. The Levee Crest bike trail south of the marina will be closed throughout construction. In the little pocket area, we'll be constructing two seepage cutoff walls and a small erosion repair. North of Sutterfield Road, we'll be constructing a conventional cutoff wall approximately 700 feet in length, shown in red here. A conventional cutoff wall is less than 80 feet in depth versus a deep cutoff wall, which is greater than 8 feet in depth. The erosion repair is located on the west side of the little pocket, shown in blue, and is approximately 30 feet in length. This is an emergency repair stemming from the 2017 flood event. On the south side of Little Pocket, we'll be constructing a deep cutoff wall approximately 1,800 feet in length. Haul routes for construction traffic in this area are along I-5, Riverside Boulevard, Piedmont Drive, Seamus Avenue, and along the Levee Crest. in the big pocket area between immediately north of Grashman Park and all the way down to the Freeport Water Intake Facility at the south of the pocket, we'll be constructing seepage cutoff walls. Specifically, we'll be constructing 9,280 feet of conventional cutoff wall and approximately 1,600 feet of deep cutoff wall. We'll also be constructing a small erosion repair, also associated with the 2017 floods. Construction of this segment of the work will take the entirety of the summer, and as such, the bike and pedestrian trail on the Levee Crest will be shut down throughout the summer. The Garcia Bend Park facility will still be open, however, the boat launch facility and its parking lot immediately against the levee will be closed throughout the summer. Haul routes for construction will be along Pocket Road, Florin Road, and Interstate 5. Let me take a minute to talk about impacts to bike trails along the project area. For the bike trails north of Broadway along the Levee Crest and south of Miller Park along the Levee Crest to Sutterville Road, will be closed throughout construction. There is a detour associated with both of these bike trail closures, which begins at Front Street and runs south along Front Street to Broadway Boulevard, east along Broadway to 5th Street, south along 5th Street to Vallejo Way, east along Vallejo Way to Riverside Boulevard, south along Riverside Boulevard until Sutterville Road, and continuing on to the Little Pocket via 25th Avenue. In the Big Pocket area, the Levee Crest bike trail will be closed throughout the entire summer during construction. There is no detour associated with this bike trail closure. However, please reference the City of Sacramento's bike trail map to find alternative routes.
As Hans described, this will be a major construction effort, and as a result, there will be direct impacts to the community. We are trying to minimize those impacts as much as possible. We have clear coordinated guidance and limitations in the contract. We require the contractor to tell us what they intend to do and how they intend to do it, and then we review it to ensure it is in compliance. We have staff dedicated to safety, quality control, and quality assurance, amongst many other disciplines. That being said, construction is large and loud and messy, and we want you to have a clear understanding of what you can expect. There's going to be a lot of truck traffic. At the peaks of degrade and rebuild, potentially 100 trucks per day. There's going to be a lot of dirt movement with heavy pieces of equipment. We need to degrade half of the levee in many places, and we will be rebuilding it prior to the next flood season. Very large construction equipment is required to construct the slurry cutoff walls, some in the ground to depths of 135 feet. That's going to cause vibration and noise. For obvious safety reasons, there will not be access to the levee, which will impact recreation to include biking and boating access. We took the extra step to gather some preliminary information from the contractor and give you some specifics of what you can expect over the spring and summer. Please note, this contract was just awarded in February, and a lot of prep paperwork has been submitted and reviewed over the past month. This is a big project and the information is very preliminary, but we want to share with you what we know as we know it. Please recognize it is subject to change. For traffic and noise, the highways and major streets impacted include Interstate 5, Front Street, Broadway, Sutterville Road, Riverside Drive, Seamus Avenue, 43rd Avenue, Riverside Boulevard, Florin Road, Pocket Road. The heaviest hauls are anticipated to be between Garcia Bend Park, Pocket Road, and I-5. Riverside Boulevard and Pocket Road are anticipated to be the primary roads used for trucks hauling material. Traffic is expected to be heavier, but is not anticipated to be a large traffic impact. There will be surveying for active migratory bird nests before and during construction. The general schedule looks like this. Seepage berm at Miller Park, construction taking place from May to July. Stability berm at Pioneer Reservoir, from July to September. You can anticipate a lot of heavy truck traffic with degrade and rebuild. At Sutterville, the degrade will be from May to July, the rebuild August to September. In the Little Pocket, the degrade is May through July and the rebuild is August to September. The Big Pocket, the degrade is April through June, and the rebuild will be in August and September. Most of the levee from downtown to the water tower will be closed throughout construction as it will be used for truck traffic. The noise vibration is primarily associated with the cutoff walls. For Sutterville, that will be taking place in June. For the Little Pocket, July through September. And for the Big Pocket, June through September. Miller Park will take place in September after Labor Day. For the bicycle paths, as Hans described, from Sutterville Road to Miller Park, there will be an alternate bike route from April to October of this year. Here is a visual of the Garcia Bend Park staging area. This will be closed from March to December. I know that this slide is quite busy. The important things to note here are that the back parking lot will be fenced off and the boat ramp will be closed. The park and the front parking will remain open to the public throughout construction. There will be a new entrance next to the tennis courts, allowing the public to enter and exit existing parking lot. Here is the win. You can see that the construction extends through December. It's important to note that the cutoff wall effort is required to be completed prior to November 1st, when the next flood season begins. That means the work at Sutterville Road and both pocket areas. The remaining work is what extends through the end of the calendar year. I hope you walk away with the following message. This is an exciting opportunity and you are all a part of it. There will be inconveniences as this is a major construction in an effort towards long-term public safety. We are trying to minimize the impacts. We have a well-thought-out plan and we will be open and honest. That being said, all plans are subject to change based on unknown and/or uncontrollable factors. This is compounded by the fact that there's an inherent risk when working under the ground. We know that you're a part of the extended team and you have a vested interest in this project. You have a right to know when things are changing that will impact you. We are committed to communicating the progress of the project with you through regular updates in email blasts, website updates, social media, and other media outlets. There will be future public meetings with each contract to communicate the specifics of the next big thing. We ask that you are patient and understanding throughout the major construction efforts and the inevitable impacts that will result. And that you remember that this effort is to reduce the risk of flooding to the number one urban flood risk in the nation, which just so happens to be our local community.